Hello and welcome to another episode of the Federal Church Presents Better Than Bloomberg, covering the 2023 global financial system collapse, where you're gonna get bored. The worst in history. Here's another good article here from Zero Hedge. This one's coming from John Rubino, I guess off his Substack there. But he describes a few of the things, just a few of the problems that these people will see as their financial system continues collapsing. And just like that, the tight money era is over. And that headline there, that title there, it's a little bit misleading, because just like you saw in that last video, wherein they did this pretty amazing thing, where they managed to make sure that credit will contract, but also made sure that hyperinflation, mega inflation, would happen. Couldn't have done it better myself. These people just managed to be screwing the third world, the shit class morons, into even more poverty that they couldn't even imagine. But, that tight money era, as in the Fed no longer printing money, that's not exactly true. It's still going to be printing trillions of dollars. But credit will be contracting at the same time. So, it's pretty amazing that they managed to do that. So at the beginning of last week, everyone expected central banks to tighten until something breaks. And yeah, their financial system broke. All the banks are insolvent. By the end of the week, it was clear that they had already broken everything. It's not an exaggeration either. It's pretty much damn near every bank that does that stuff by convention. So, two middling U.S. banks imploded. European mega bank Credit Suisse, finally died a well-justified death. Well, see, that's the thing. That was already in trouble. So, it wasn't the dipshit trade that brought that down, which is why this stupid little media hoopla saying that, oh my god, Credit Suisse is bailed out, everything is now okay. It's almost like a distraction. Because the actual problem isn't the Swiss bank. It's the problem that all these dipshitters did the dipshit trade. And, in a sense, Credit Suisse really has nothing to do with it. Even though it was a bank on its way to be, already in trouble for several years. But the situation at hand, because of rising rates and dipshits who should not be running banks, you now have a failure of the banking system. So, and the who's next speculation ran wild. Well, there's plenty next. It's just like the media darling now for who's next is PacWest. But yes, there will be plenty more next. And just like that, the era of tight money ended. Again, that's a misnomer there. Credit will contract, but you will get massive hyperinflation with printed money. Amazing how they did it. So now the world's monetary authorities have broadened the definition of systemic risk to cover pretty much anything. And again, it wasn't systemic risk. Is that the system was full of dipshits. FDIC insurance has been extended to every bank account of any size, i.e. massive money printing. So, Credit Suisse is being bought for pennies on the dollar by rival Swiss giant UBS, and according to Bloomberg, and again, this is something just a rumor. The Federal Reserve and five other central banks announced coordinated action on Sunday to boost liquidity in U.S. dollar swap arrangements, the latest effort by policymakers to ease growing strains in the global financial system. Central banks involved in the dollar swaps will increase the frequency of seven-day maturity operations from weekly to daily. The Fed said in a statement coordinated with the Bank of Canada, the Bank of England, Bank of Japan, ECB, and S&P. Fed's balance sheet. And again, so that's kind of how you can tell what these people are doing. So they communicate with each other, the ECB raises rates. You can assume that the Fed will raise rates too, which is what they did. but the Fed's balance sheet will measure how much currency it creates and dumps into the economy. Trillions, shitloads of hyperinflation, had been shrinking, which is to say the U.S. money supply had been contracting. Now it's soaring, up $300 billion in a matter of days. I.e. the shit class morons get poor. Purposes there. And the beautiful part is with that massive money printing, the MMP there, they also managed to contract credit, which means the shit class morons lose their jobs in the millions. Piecemeal fingers in the dike character of this response can be explained in one of two ways. Either the morons running the global financial system, actually the morons at the banks who should be running depository institutions, dipshits, were completely blindsided because they actually thought rising interest rates and a falling money supply would slow inflation without unintended consequences. Again, the dipshits just seem to think that it would be a good idea buying toiletries with massive money printing and rising interest rates. Not a falling money supply. Because they would have to fall a lot for them to cover that $7 trillion of fucking mess they made within only 2 years, 3 years. You know, that's in addition to the trillions they already had. Not to mention their unfunded liabilities. Despite a century of contrary experience, or the evil geniuses running the global financial system have engineered a multifaceted crisis as an excuse to assume total control. Well, if they did, they are pretty genius, because they managed to make sure credit would contract, to put the shit into poverty, and then, you know, as in job losses, etc., reduction of standard of living, and, you know, because all these idiots have is buying stuff off credit. And even better, hyperinflation from the massive money printing to make sure that they can't afford anything in inflation. It's genius to me. I am agnostic on the above, but in either case, it seems clear that the world's governments won't be able to stop conditions from deteriorating. Consider, lenders were already scared. Now they're terrified. Banks were already tightening credit standards before last week's flash crisis. And this is the best part. There won't be any banks to tighten credit standards. There won't be any fucking banks to be originating any debt. That's the best part. Now, virtually all of them will stop lending to any but their strongest clients. A year from now, the updated version of this chart will show a spike to record high tightening levels. And this is an even better one. Autos are a bursting bubble. You know, these people, it's an economic contraction. And all these cars are being repoed already. You know, because nobody can afford anything. They can't get any real jobs. They can't afford anything in the inflation. And they're getting repoed. Very much, very much a karma. So, get it? Karma? Yeah. The number of underwater car loans, where the loan balance exceeds the value of the car, has been rising for months. Interest rates on used car loans have jumped from an average 8% to over 10% the past year, and auto loan delinquency rates have climbed to their highest level in over 15 years, with an especially big jump among subprime borrowers. Now, panic banks will make car loans even harder to get, while a growing number of borrowers will default on the existing loans. Now, again, let's think about why this happened. Because you didn't donate Rolls Royces to the church. Again, link, or not link, email address and Bitcoin wallets there below, by the way. And now all these people are going to lose their cars or lose their ability to buy cars. Because you upset the Jesus. That's why that happened. So they will be harder to get loans, while a growing number of borrowers will default on their existing loans, especially when millions of them lose their jobs. Typical recession behavior, but this time against a crisis backdrop. Yeah, it's one hell of a crisis. The entire banking system is imploding. Oh, this is ridiculous, dude. Commercial real estate was toast in any event, but now it's burnt toast. Let me get another example of real estate. And it'll also go to residential real estate as well. Office buildings, warehouses, and such never fully recovered from the pandemic lockdowns. And by the fourth quarter of 2022, delinquencies on commercial real estate loans were rising sharply. Building prices were beginning to fall, and the specter of a commercial real estate crash was looming. And that was before banks and regulators went into their current panic mode. Yeah. This again happened. You didn't donate those beachfront mansions. You don't need them here on Earth. You should only be concerned with what you have in heaven. And here on Earth, you're not going to have those houses either, or that commercial real estate. Not unlike the bus apocalypse over here, where they'll get a lot of repos and a lot of new bus riders. A little bit of the Jesus there for crowding on the bus too, by the way. So, now just try refinancing an underperforming office complex and see how it goes. Okay. And here's the garbage, you know. Now I'm making a beautiful view. And there's more. Stephanie Pomboy, an analyst whose work has been spot on lately, tweeted this 12 hours ago.
You know what's keeping me up at night? Thinking about the unseen exposure by non-bank financial institutions to far riskier than the stuff bringing down the banks.
And again, I guess that's funny because the stuff bringing down the banks are the U.S. treasuries, which are supposedly risk-free, but the dipshits had no comprehension of the environment in which that was to be considered risk-free. So especially the prospect that some insurer and counterparty of the giant market of credit derivatives, that's the best part, when all of them blow up because the derivatives, even if it was hedged, somebody has to pay off the hedge. So now all these banks blow up, all these institutions blow up, and you're done. Your financial system's done. It's about to go toes up. And don't even get me started on the pensions. Pensions are gone, just like you saw that Swedish one in another video we made. That was just one example of the many that will fail, of the many companies that will fail, that the many companies will, especially zombie companies, will just cease to exist in the credit contraction there. Granted breathlessly on that, they will be on the subject of a bailout the likes of which we have never before witnessed. And again, that's actually something these people are counting on.
Oh, they'll just bail it out. They can't let it go. Blah, blah, blah.
Well, yeah, they can. They absolutely can. And even if they did bail it out, you're now poorer in inflation. For instance, that was what was probably coming in normal times. As for the derivatives, well, they'll destroy the world eventually, so why not now? Why not? The takeaway, in the midst of all the various credit crises, controlling inflation will be moved to the back burner. No, that actually will be damn near impossible to do. It won't matter in any case because, well, they die in the inflation, or they end up in poverty in the inflation. I mean, companies, fail. Yeah, it will be there, and the world will realize that the central banks are out of ammo, and they are. But have no choice but to let their currencies burn. Again, in inflation. And they can try to burn as much currency as they can to try to slow it down in the meantime. But in the end, the shit classes get bored. And they will see unimaginable amounts of poverty. As they deserve, actually. And again, don't forget why this happened. It's because you didn't donate, and the Jesus and the God is extremely mad at you. Make sure to pay your tithe. Right there, the Bitcoin wallet below in the description there. Make sure to donate, because the collapse does get worse.